I'm Santo Bains, and this is Canary, the vlog dedicated to the amazing wines of the Canary Islands. In the last episode, we got kind of heavy, kind of emotional, when we looked at Nelson's failed attempt to invade Santa Cruz to Tenerife. So we're going to be a little more chilled out in this episode. We're heading up to the northeasternmost island of the Canaries, Lanzarote, which has the biggest white wine producing appellation of the entire archipelago. Lanzarote's viticultural landscape is spectacular and completely unique in the world, but we're gonna save that for a future episode. What I wanna do in this show is to compare and contrast two dry white wines to demonstrate the difference that a grape variety can make to the aromatic profile of a wine. Way back, when I was in my early 20s, I really didn't know very much about wine at all. And I think I thought that most white wines tasted more or less the same. I know now that this is completely incorrect, but you don't have to take my word for it. What you might do is get these two wines, rewatch this show, and taste along with me. And hopefully that will help to establish how different the aromatics of a wine can be just by changing the grape type alone. In many ways, these wines are very similar. They're both from Lanzarote, of course. They are from grapes that were grown in 2019. They are from vineyards that are just a stone's throw away from one another. They were both made into wine in the same winery, Los Bermejos, by the same winemaker, a fellow named Ignacio Valdera. They were both fermented in stainless steel, and they are both ecological wines. So the use of artificial pesticides and fertilizers and the like were avoided during the growing season. The only significant difference between these two wines is that this one on my right is from a grape called Malvasía Volcánica, which is the child of two other grapes from the Canary Islands. If you remember back to episode one, we looked at wines from a grape called Malvasía Aromática. So Malvasía Aromática has been crossed with another local grape called Marmajuelo to produce Malvasía Volcánica, and it is grown abundantly. It is the most common grape of Lanzarote. On my left, I have a wine from a grape called Diego, which is genetically identical to a minority grape variety that is grown in southern mainland Spain. It's not very abundant in Spain or in the Canary Islands, but it is becoming more common in recent years, which I'm really pleased about because I really like it. Okay, enough preamble. Let's get into this. What I want to do first is to look to see if there is any color difference between these two wines. I'm not expecting much, but we'll see what we see. Okay, so they are both more or less the same color. Let's just top up the Malvasía a little bit. So both a pale straw yellow. I've got this white piece of paper in front of me, which lets you pick out color details a little better sometimes. And I'd say in the natural light here, if we look more closely at these side by side though, there is a slight difference. I would say the Diego on my left side has a little bit of a greenish reflection to it, whereas the Malvasía Volcánica has a little more of an orange hue to it, which is interesting because the grapes at harvest time, when they're ripe, of these two varieties, have slightly different colors. And that is quite accurately reflected in the color profile that we're getting right now. Let's sniff and taste these. We'll try the Diego first. Really fresh on the nose. Quite subtle aromas. Some freshly cut white flowers. Maybe even a tiny bit of freshly cut grass. and some subtle bitter notes as well, almost like juniper berries, and maybe a little fennel as well. And in terms of fruit, I would say it's citrusy, but on the lemon-lime side. See what it tastes like? So really powerful upfront acidity. Really cleansing. The flavors that I was talking about before coming through quite strongly. And what I'd say is that the entry is very angular in a way, almost steely in terms of its character. And a nice long finish, actually. You know, while the entry might be angular and quite direct, it actually smooths and mellows quite a bit on the back palate and has a really nice, pleasant finish. Let's have a drink of water. Okay, let's try out this Malvasía Volcánica. So, really big nose on this wine. Really, really floral, but a different kind of floral. This is blossoming. And the fruit aromas are more stone fruits, peaches, nectarines, that sort of thing. So the smell is completely different. Actually, pretty good acidity in this wine as well. A little citrusy, orange, grapefruit, a little bit. But what really dominates are those aromas and flavors of stone fruits and the blossom, peach blossom, that sort of thing as well. And the entry is completely different between these two wines. With the Diego, it was quite direct, quite sharp, quite angular, like I said, whereas it's much rounder in the Malvasía. Much more floral, and the back palate follows through with a lot of floral and fruity notes. For me, when I visualize the difference between these two grapes and these two wines, Diego is like a square, whereas the Malvasía Volcánica is like a circle. And, you know, of course, it's highly potent in terms of its perfume, which no doubt it's getting a lot of that from its parent, Malvasía Aromatica. But two completely different wines from just changing the grape type alone. So, funny story I heard from the winemaker of a neighboring bodega, one called El Grifo, is about the many rabbits that there are in Lanzarote. So apparently the rabbits cause a problem as a pest to the grapes, especially late on in the season, just before harvest, when they go around and eat a lot of the grapes that they can reach. Now, interestingly, the problem is much more severe when it comes to Malvasía Volcánica. Apparently the rabbits have a preference, and they don't really like the tanginess, the high acidity and chewiness of the thick skins of the Diego grape. They'd much rather have the floral Malvasía Volcánica. Do I agree with the rabbits? No, I don't think so. I really like both of these wines a lot. They're a completely different style, but I think either of them would be sensational to have on holiday in Lanzarote, chilled, either on their own or with any of the fantastic seafood that is so commonly caught in the Canary Islands. Now, will you have a preference for one of these grapes or one of these wines over the other? Well, that's entirely up to you. But I would urge you, while you're in Lanzarote or here in the UK, to try wines from these grapes side by side. Because if you're anything like I was in my early 20s and you think most white wines taste more or less the same, then I think you could find the exercise quite illuminating. And at the very least, you'll end up with two open bottles of wine that you're drinking. Cheers.